on this episode of A Moment with Legacy. Trainee crew members playing a game of Lost in Translation. Each of the trainee crew members will be learning a choreography from our resident instructor, Chelsea Montero. However, neither Chelsea nor the trainee crew members are able to see each other. Trainee crew members have to decipher the choreography entirely from a verbal description. Will the trainee crew be as one with Chelsea, or will they be lost in translation? Let the games begin!
And we're just gonna do the counting first, okay? So the counting goes 6, 7, 8. You let go one, you're gonna start on the two, okay? So I'll just count 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the first step, you let go one on the two end, your right elbow is gonna come up and your left elbow is just gonna straighten out, swing out to the side.
Left side.
Then it's going to draw like a halo over my head. So basically my right hand just wants to draw a halo over my head by going from my right ear to the back of my head and then coming front. Now as you go forward, it's kind of like a kick, not really a kick, but like a release. Right, release forward, out to the right. Like a rond de jambe anglais. Okay, so you just kick the right leg forward, let it swing out to the right side.
Forward, release to the right. So my end position is that my feet are side by side. But open
side by side. So side by side, but open?
Yeah, you see your feet together. And then you step out your right leg to the side.
Oh, this is my left leg. I've been swinging my left leg.
Like a ball change, you're gonna travel to your left and your legs are gonna go ball change right left, right left.
Trainee Crew is basically the graduates for our core program, the Legacy Experience. These are for students who wish to pursue dance and take it to the next level.
We groom our Trainee Crew members through platforms and opportunities like choreographing for open classes, creating pieces and items. They also get to train with our main crew members, their teachers, and are also mentored in dance education.
So it's like a 5, 6 and, then your knees will be xiao ben. Xiao Bao. I feel like she's struggling over there.
Do the sit, sit, sit. My hands are gonna go right hand shoot out to the right side. Then left hand shoot out to the left side. And then bring your arms into the front.
Yes, yeah, very K-pop inspired this part. Your last two steps, you just bring your right knee to your left knee, and at the same time when you do that, you tap your ankle.
My right hand tap my right ankle. So you just think of
tap my right ankle, put it down. Tap my left ankle, put it down.
What?
7N was not
too bad. What's the 7N?
Yes. First part was completely like different. It was so different.
No, it's only until the power parade.
Okay,
then.
We watched again.
I think the very first move, I was like, really? I saw the tapping one, it was...
You said right hand, then the thing is when you said right hand to left ankle. But then I thought about the ankle going that side, then I was like, this doesn't make sense. So I tapped this side. I was like, wait.
No, but I repeated so many times, right hand, right ankle. But you still do right
hand. No, you said right hand, right ankle, then I heard right hand, left ankle. Ankle. So never mind this side.
To tap your left ankle with your right hand. Eh? Tap your right ankle with your right hand.
Can also lah. That was good, man.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for learning it. Should we do like a how you felt in that moment? Thought and what you were feeling.
Because I'm a visual learner.
Excuses.
Excuse me, ma'am?
Yeah. Okay, Chels' classes are already hard even if I can see her. Without seeing her, I was struggling. But then she'll explain it really clearly, like...
You see it?
Like, yeah. I mean, she's sitting right here, so I have to say it. But she'll say things like shoulder, touch the shoulder, or at elbow level. Yeah, so it makes a lot of sense. But it's just that I still did my own version, I think. Like, I did not understand the assignment.
Interpretation different. It's like she said something, then I'm like, huh? Then I thought behind the screen, I'm like, okay, I'm doing well, like this is the move. And then I watched and
not the move.
Because I'm a visual learner. But I think it really plays a part. Because when Chels say, okay, hands come together, then like yeah. So there is so many ways to get there. And I think everyone interprets move differently. And I think it's just like the strength of all of us. I think it's shown very clearly in the movements that we picked and, you know, like the style that we fall back on when
even despite the fact that it's Chels' corridor.
I always think like, Chels wouldn't do that.
Right, yeah.
That's
what I was totally wrong. This is not Chels.
I'm a chameleon. Yeah, but I think another great thing is because we had that barrier, like I found that there was no, watching you guys, there was no influence of my dancing and my styling in your movements. So I think if people out there who are like struggling with like identity or what in dance, and like maybe this is a good practice where you literally just use your like audio guides to move, and then really like you just let your body move the way it wants to rather than always like copying a specific person or copying an instructor. Yeah, so that was really fun. I thought that was great. Oh, you beautiful.
Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this episode of A Moment with Legacy. If you want to know more about the Legacy experience, do drop by our website at www.legacydanceco.com.sg.
We'll see you guys in the next one.
Just me.